But again, that completely lacks perspective, because in the 1980s, Catholics in the world were losing 4 or 5 people per day who would convert to a different form of Christianity, normally Pentecostalism. Now, in the 1980s, there was no Church of Almighty God, meaning that there is continuously a number of people who will leave the Roman Catholic Church or the historical Protestant churches and become Mormons or Jehovah's Witnesses or Pentecostal or even Buddhist. In Italy, we have a large phenomenon of Catholics becoming Buddhists. So religious mobility is a typical character of postmodernity and globalization. So people change religion all the time. It's not the fault of the Church of Almighty God. Some people will join the Church of Almighty God, some other people will join the Jehovah's Witnesses or the Trio Buddha School or Soka Gakkai or whatever. So if people leave the traditional religions and goes away, the traditional religions should not accuse the Church of Almighty God or the Mormons or Jehovah's Witnesses of sheep stealing, but they should ask themselves why people are leaving, what's wrong with us. And by the way, if we go to statistics on a worldwide scale, traditional Christianity, Roman Catholic Church, and traditional Protestant churches, they are losing more members to atheism or religious indifference than they are losing to other religions. So, meaning people go away because they are not happy about traditional religions, and they go in many different directions. Mostly they go to religious indifference. Not really even militant atheism. Religious, I just don't care about religion. And millions of people leave traditional churches and seek into religious indifference every year. And then some go to other religions. But the fact that this religious mobility is such a global phenomenon, and it existed before the Church of Almighty God, it shows that it's a normal phenomenon. You cannot blame the Church of Almighty God for the fact that traditional religions are losing members in many countries. Well, there is no trademark Christianity registered in any patent office, so the name Christian, it's a theological category, and it's dispute between theologians, which should have nothing to do with religious liberty or registering the churches or the law. I mean, from the point of view of a certain Catholic or evangelical theologian, they may adopt a narrow definition of Christianity, come to the conclusion that the Church of Almighty God is not Christian. Just to tell you a very simple example, for some conservative evangelicals and fundamentalists in the United States, their definition of Christianity is as such that they came to the conclusion that Catholicism is not Christian. And for some very conservative Catholics, not the official Roman Catholic Church, but there are very arch-conservative Catholics which will say the Protestants are not Christian. But that's all a theological controversy which would have nothing to do with the law. So it all depends how you define Christianity. If you adopt a broader definition of Christianity, then the Church of Almighty God is Christian because it believes that the same God revealed himself as God the Father or Jehovah, as Jesus Christ, and as the Almighty God. If you adopt a strict definition of Christianity, you can conclude that the Church of Almighty God is not Christian, and that many other groups are not Christian. But that depends on, it's a question of theology, and I believe theologians should be very free to debate their respective ideas in their universities or in Christian publications, but that should have nothing to do with a secular state like Hong Kong or any other modern state.